Thank you. Before I start, I would like to thank Linda for making my job easier today. And I hope you guys in the back can hear me loudly because I'm quite soft-spoken. Before I start, assalamu alaikum, everyone. And welcome to Dubai for anyone who just flew in. I believe some people just arrived. And good morning. Sorry, I forget to say that in English. Before I start, I would require the clicker. Is there a clicker for me? It'll come? Okay. So, my story today is basically complementing what Linda has actually informed us about. Mainly about people. Yes, we work in HR, and I believe we all know HR processes. We are all familiar with the HR black box. I can't find it. Thank you. We are all familiar with the HR being black box. Nobody knows what happens. They only greet people when they come in. And they basically shake the hands or not shake even the hands while leaving the company. I can see some smiles on the front. Is that correct? Yeah? Everything is confidential about HR. And when I started my career, it was like, shh, don't say that. It's confidential. Why are things really confidential in HR? So by creating Tanfeeth, I had a clear I would say a target in mind, to move away from the black box. For how long we will keep everything confidential in HR, it's about time to actually start sharing and talking to people rather than hiding things and keeping it for the annual appraisal. So this is just an introductory. I'll just tell you more about Tanfeeth's story and what we have done in creating different kind of HR, different than the corporate HR that we see today among most of the companies. Sorry, it's an IT problem as usual. So, green button, I forgot that. So, I started my career as a fresh graduate. And during those days, they used to promote the roles in the banking sector because they had a mandate from the government to hire more fresh graduates. And I actually joined as a trainee, where basically I got rotated across retail banking, corporate, HR, and then I ended up in HR, although I'm an IT graduate. But if you ask me today about any system, I have no clue. I've completely forgotten about IT. And then I joined Emirates MBD, that was before the merger. And after that, we have created awesome company that I'm today working for by the name of Tanfeeth. I know that you might not be familiar with Tanfeeth or what's the idea behind actually creating the company. Why Emirates MBD Group thought of creating a new subsidiary beside the other subsidiaries that they already have? First of all, we all know the crisis that we went through in 2008, yes? We all were there, and we saw how things actually changed. Overnight, people started losing their jobs. And maybe we weren't really prepared for a crisis. We've never seen a crisis in this part of the world. For me, it was the first time. It was first time seeing a merger, which basically Emirates Bank and National Bank of Dubai, and then seeing a crisis as well. So we've ended up with an estimated market size of 7 billion. And that was the market share at that time. And I'm talking about 2010 data, so don't catch me with the numbers because we're talking history here in 2010. And we wanted to create a shared service for both of the banks where basically we start consolidating all the back office. Customer got stuck on the other side whenever calling the bank, where basically where two banks moved to one bank, they will probably get the right answer, but said in a different way. And the reason was because we had so many back offices all over the UAE. We also wanted to create training grounds for young Emiratis to actually join us in a BPO industry and then move to the banking industry or to the government. And here our story actually started. This is our head office in Maidan. So when we initially started, we were 20 full-time employees. And we were stuck in one of the meeting room, actually, at that time. We slowly start growing by moving more processes from the bank back office to Tanfeeth. So we moved to be around 1,100 employees at that time. After some time, a floor could not actually fit all of us. So they've decided to get us a building that was in Maidan. And today we actually bought the second building. We are over 2,500 employees today, mainly in back office between a call center and backup process, basically a processing center for Emirates NBD, EBI, and Network International. I will talk about the human element more than what we have done or what sort of basically achievement we've done when it comes to P&L, profits, and efficiency that we brought in. I'll talk mainly about the people, and this is my team actually, who are jumping there and then the photo. In Tanfeeth, as I said, we wanted to create different HR, no more black box. It's a colorful box and young, and actually they're mobile. They walk around, they talk to you, they encourage you. We have 47 nationalities, and you can imagine if you walk into a floor, very diverse. You see all kinds of people that you may come across, and you wanted to actually answer all their questions in the same way. Hence, we've also hired diverse line HR, and you can see them clearly there. As I said, over 2,000 employees, average age is 29, and you can imagine how young the population are actually in that small building. When you walk in, they love to take selfies. This whole fascination about selfies in the lift, in the corridor, they'll keep clicking selfies and posting their photos. So slowly you get engaged with them and you try to build your culture around your people. So this is just a brief on how does it look like today? Why do we have very young population in the company? So when actually I was given this piece of project by saying, we're creating a shared service, create an HR function that actually can evolve around people. And here we started drawing how our future HR should look like. That was back in 2010. So first of all, having an engaged culture, very engaged culture, and I'm saying it like right to the bone. If you are not truly engaged and understanding the purpose of why you have joined really Tanfeeth and what do you want to end up learning from this company, then you might not be the right person for me. Hence, we do give feedback, as Linda said. Actually, we give feedback every day. And people are normally asked, do you want it to be sugar-coated or not? I think I was the only one who said, please give it to me. No sugar-coating, just give it. And it's a perception that females cannot handle feedback. How can we give her feedback? I'm the only female in the executive committee. For me, it was really overwhelming seeing all these men around in the meeting room. It was overwhelming for them to actually tell them that I need a crystal clear feedback. If you don't like a certain behavior, tell me. Don't sugarcoat it because I'm a female. And you assume that I'll break on tears. I won't. I'll take it positively and I'll carry on. How many of you today get feedback? I can't see hands. No, despite Tanfeeth table. Do you get feedback from your managers? Not from manager, from colleagues, spouse. I doubted that you guys get feedback from spouse. So feedback is a key. If you don't get it, please go back tomorrow and ask your line manager for feedback. It's not only giving, it's receiving, and how do you receive it? Yeah, first time you might not like it, because you are probably not used to it. After some time, you get used to it, and you keep asking for it. So for us, very engaged employees that we have. I told you, they take selfies for any reason. Sometimes we find it quite funny, but this is the way they are. They are engaged, and they are giving me what I want. In terms of return on investment, I'm getting it. Actually, my financial results are beyond expectation to my main board. The second element, I'm the only company today that actually hire fresh graduate. When I say fresh graduate, I mean at the age of 18. And technically, I'm supporting two banks. So initially, these guys will join me as fresh graduate and then move as bankers in the bank, be it Emirates Islamic or EMBD. And this is the way I package the role. I come to, well, let me actually share a fact with you. I pay lower than the market, and I actually say it proudly in open forums. I pay lower, but I invest a lot in actually bringing up these calibers. After 2 or 3 years, they become private banker employees in Emirates MBD. And I tell you what we have done for them. How many of you here have kids? MashaAllah. Do they talk to you face to face? No. They WhatsApp you. صح? Yeah. And sometimes you just see their Snapchat and you don't know where they are. Correct? The world has changed. I don't meet my parents except on Friday. At least I'm from the old generation. So I still have a Friday as my family day, and I have that family meal where we actually talk. And trust me, I can't leave my phone. I keep chit-chatting with the guys from the bank, from Tanfeeth, and you know, answering all my groups. It's the same thing with the employees. They want their promotion on a click of a button. They want everything as if yesterday. They don't want it today. They don't want really to be told what to be done. It's the same with your children. Okay, I know it, khalas. I know I have to do this. I think you hear this every day. You should be back home at around 8. Yes, khalas, I know it. WhatsApp me. I'll WhatsApp you once you come because probably you'll be sleeping. This kind of answer, we do hear it on the floors. Hence, we actually built our training capabilities around what do they really want? Do they really want to be called to a training room where they sit for a full day getting trained? They want an app that actually can sit on their mobile phone or iPads, and they can log in anytime. This is how our Tanfeeth University look like today. And we made it a bit similar to Facebook, because you know how Facebook is popular. And they have chat rooms, they can send direct messages to the trainers, to their managers, and for us, it was easier to track their progress in completing different certification across. So today we have around 38 models, and we're still developing more models to actually upload it. We cannot upload everything on Tanfeeth University because we're still supporting a banking system. So as a part of privacy, we cannot actually put everything on that portal. However, most of the soft skill training are there up and running. And most of the guys get trained while they're on the bus. Most of my population actually lives in Sharjah, and they travel like 4 hours every day from Sharjah to Dubai, and the other way around. So by being in the stuck in traffic, which is normal in Dubai nowadays, it's BAU traffic, they actually log into their app and try to complete more of certification. And again, the whole idea was building a system that is suitable for the agents and what do they really want. So today they are driving their own career progression. We don't force them to go and complete certain trainings. If you want to get promoted, you know the way to it. We talk about the lower population, basically, I would say, mostly the agents, my customer-facing agents, and we put Tanfeeth University for them. We actually moved starting last year, focusing on middle management, and which we haven't really focused on earlier when we built the company. So for us was more to think out of the box and see what kind of skills do we need to bring in to actually get in sync with the values and the mission and vision we have put across. So first of all, we've developed courses for the young Emiratis, my brothers and sisters who are fresh out of high school. I hire non-Emiratis, actually fresh graduates from universities. But when it comes to UAE National, I hire high school leavers. And that actually put them, I would say, in a competition with the other population because they are not really university graduates. Hence, they would require extra help to actually bring them up the curve and ensure that they actually understand the banking processes. Hence, we have built training programs only for them. We've also faced an issue with the underwriters when the market was booming. We started losing our underwriter employees. So we created a program where we can ensure that the talent will actually fly in from different parts of Tanfeeth, and I don't have to go externally and hire. How many of you hire externally today if someone resigns? All of you hire externally. Yes, oil. And the reason is, probably operation leader will come back saying, I don't have enough talent in the company, let's go external. External person will actually bring in different kind of expertise. And Tanfeeth, none of the operation manager can come back telling me that. Because I believe I do have a talent in-house and I can promote them. Last year we had over 500 promotions across Tanfeeth. So I don't go actually externally and hire unless I'm really stuck with a different set of skills that I cannot find. But the rest of the promotion comes from the pool itself. We advertise, they complete the training, and then they apply. So it's very clear to the agents. Again, the rest is actually a follow-up, interviewing skills, because we keep interviewing for each and every job. We also complemented all the training with a tie-up with New York University in Abu Dhabi, and we're currently running the second batch. But we have, what we have done differently with 2016 batch is we actually have tie up with Disney Institute for Leadership. So my top performer will actually fly to Disney next week to learn more about customer experience. I can see the smiles. Yes, we all love Disney. But how do they hire and how do they sustain? The stories are quite similar when it comes to impressing the audience and our employees as well. So this is part of keeping them engaged, and we tell them that we really care about your development, and this is how we are rewarding you. Okay. Moving forward, implementing the HR support. Again, talking about youngsters on the floor, putting the right training tool for them. They wanted to have a shoulder to go to whenever they get bullied by the manager, basically, we all get bullied at a point of, at one point or another. So we ensure that every 100 employees get a line HR who actually sit on the floor to support them, hear them out, put an engagement plan accordingly. So before actually a problem become a serious issue, they will be able to actually solve it and come up with solution. So we moved from the traditional way of conducting surveys every year. We do have it on a monthly basis. Feedback is given, and we try to help both, not only the operation leaders, but also the agents to understand what is expected from them. Weekly engagement calendar. And I'll tell you more, actually, on my following slide about the engagement calendar. Career management. We all want to know what's next for us, and how do I know that actually the company is looking after my career progression? How does it work? Sitting for an assessment, isn't it? And then having a crystal clear plan that tells me within the next few months you will be attending so-and-so training, and this is what is required from you in order to sustain your level and move forward. So each employee today in Tanfeeth got something called PDP, Performance Development Plan, that clearly detailed what is expected and what are the gaps that that person would require to work on in order to move forward. Let's go back to the fun part. Do you guys get ice creams in your companies today? Ice cream? No? You don't get anything free from your company? No. I like the smiles on the front row. No, so basically you don't get anything. Okay, come over to Tanfeeth. We'll tell you what we do. So many things. I mean, I won't read everything there. Our biggest hit was Ice Cream Day. So line HR, you know, they keep brainstorming about different activities, and they were like, fine, let's offer free ice cream per employee. So for me was, how much is that? They were like, don't worry, we'll get a corporate deal. And actually, we ended up getting a free deal because for them, it was marketing. So we got in the ice cream, we ensured that each employee get a coupon where they go, and they actually receive an ice cream. So we're like, fine, happy, you could see the queues, people are receiving their ice cream. And I got a bunch of people who were really mad at me. And they were like, you know you were diabetic? At least you could have considered our situation and get a different kind of ice cream. So my first impression was like, oops, I'm sorry, I didn't know, and I didn't know that actually sugar-free ice cream exists with these guys. So the following year, we ensured that we have two lines. One line, the healthy guys who can go and obtain any kind of ice cream, and sugar-free for the rest of the population. So unless we actually go down to the employees and hear from them, we wouldn't know what they're thinking about. And as Linda correctly said, were very much engaged. We actually encouraged the employees to come and speak. They actually speak their mind. They speak everything. You can't imagine like the details that we actually know about the employees while walking around. They have so many bright ideas that they want somebody to sponsor and run with. The other idea that actually came from the floor was Make-A-Wish. And I'll play a video at the very end to tell you more about the Make-A-Wish campaign and how did it work. Basically, we've asked people to drop their wishes for the year. And by having 2,000 employees, most of them were like, nah, what are you going to get me if I actually drop my wish in that box? And so they were floating around with a box. And after 1 month, they saw the CEO walking around with gifts. And they were like, what's going on? It's not really Valentine. There are gifts around. What is it? And then the CEO was handing over their wishes. So their wishes were something simple like a pillow for a wife. I don't know why one of the guys asked for a pillow for a wife. So that was nicely wrapped by the line HR. lip glosses for girlfriends. I had personally to go and shop for those lip glosses. Makeup, shoes, you can imagine stuff. A fish, we had a goldfish actually. That was one of the wishes. But for the employees to see the CEO himself coming and delivering their wishes, that had the biggest impact on the floor. They were really happy to see how the company is actually looking after them and considering their wishes as basically as a command. And they made me and the rest of my line HR running around in the shopping mall for one full week actually shopping for all the employees. But none of our wishes were granted because we were doing all the fun stuff. So this is just one element of the HR function in Tanfeeth. Moving forward and going back to what Linda again said, data and analytics. Actually, I have removed that slide earlier. My apology for that. Data, if you look at the data today, how many data do you have in every company? Over 1.2 million kind of data, everything. Let's think of printing that sheet. The first thing we will all be looking at, the salaries. It's like automatically our eyes goes to salaries, isn't it? But what does it really mean if we don't really use the tool that help us to understand what is this data is all about? And Linda again correctly said, Google, they do so many analysis bases, the data that they have. And this is what we have done. We actually hired a company, ClearSight, to help us actually get a crack of what do we have, how our data look like, and what kind of decisions we can actually make, being leaders of the organization. And we clearly ended up thinking of expanding our business out of Dubai, and we wanted to set up a call center in the UAE. And if you look at the data here, it clearly says there are no talent in Dubai. I wouldn't say talent, job seekers, who really wants to join call center workforce in Dubai. Based on the data, we actually moved to Ras Al Khaimah. And I'm talking about actively looking for jobs. We will be having graduates, but they will choose not actually to join the workforce. And I will be mainly talking about females. So we just started our call center in Ras Al Khaimah. And there is a clear reason is why we have moved out of Dubai. I already have my main call center in Dubai, but we wanted to branch out. We actually explored Fujairah, Al Ain, and we ended up with Ras Al Khaimah. And the reason for Ras Al Khaimah, because there were more job seekers and graduates in Ras Al Khaimah. We all know that the females of Ras Al Khaimah won't commute every day to Dubai or Abu Dhabi. They would prefer to have something there in the city to actually work. And speaking of which, we just opened our call center in Ras Al Khaimah, which hopefully is going to be 100 Emiratis, and I'm talking females Emiratis. And I'm not saying that because I'm biased, because none of the males actually have applied for a call center job yet. Hence, my 30 employees so far are all females in Ras Al Khaimah. And we'll hopefully go live from Ras Al Khaimah line beginning of April. So that is part of us actually supporting the community and ensuring that we reach out to the people and we give them job opportunities as well. So moving away from the data and bearing in mind the time, Tanfeeth is only 5 years old, and I believe we put so many processes that actually got recognized by other well-known firms in the globe. So I won't talk about how much we have brought into Emirates MBD, that is already mentioned there, but I'll talk about the stuff that I'm really proud of. I mean, getting recognized by organizations in the US. So we won around 5 awards, starting from gold all the way to bronze for all our training certification that we have put into place. Again, IQPC for the call center, but the one that I'm really proud of is basically Harvard business case, where although at that time we were around 4 years old, they've decided to put a whole business case about Tanfeeth and about the values that we actually bring into the employees as part of their MBA classes. That's what really makes us proud of what we have created and ensure that we actually can keep focusing on our people in order to develop a better life for them in the company. Before I close, and I know it shows zero here, I'll just show you a video that will actually recap what I have just said. Oops, I don't know how the video works. Sorry, it's another IT problem. I don't know how does this work. Can somebody just tell me? Okay. So it's not an IT problem. Yeah? Shall I close? Yeah. Oh, okay. Fine. So, well, basically, the video was about making some dreams come true for one of the airlines in the US where they have granted their wishes during Christmas. And that spirit that actually touches all the passenger hearts. And in a summary, this is what we are trying to do in Tanfeeth HR, is touching the employee's heart by actually reaching out to them rather than them reaching out to us. With this, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thanks a lot for your patience, and I'll be more than happy to answer any question.
So much, Hessa. So at the beginning, is there any question from the floor? Would anyone like to ask Hessa a question? So I've got some for you. You talked about all of these wonderful things you do at Tanfeeth, but if you want to choose the single most important engagement strategy that you have implemented based on the results you got, what would you choose?
I think, well, I would say from my own opinion, what actually worked well with us is launching Tanfeeth University app. Really actually spoke their language clearly, and it's helping them. So whenever I see that the license, number of licenses are actually increasing, it says a lot that the people are getting the benefit out of it, and they're training themselves in order to actually give more to the organization. And that's what I want, return on investment. So I believe Tanfeeth University is like my number one today in my engagement.
Great. And you collect a lot of data points.
Yes.
How do you make sure you don't get overwhelmed with all of these data and that you're looking at the right data?
We basically, first of all, we try at what problem we're trying to solve. Is it cost? What is it exactly? So every quarter you will have a different agenda as a business to look at. So if it is cost, then I will download anything that has to do with cost and try to work on some problems as well. So it would vary actually from time to time on what is my agenda.
Thank you so much, Hessa. Let's give her a big round of applause.